Number 11.
The first stop on this train ride is Browntown.
Infectious disease specialist Chris Van Tullekan ran a study in 2016 testing the hands of 50 random people across London. What he found was that 30% of people had fecal matter under their fingernails. The primary culprit for this abhorrently high number is the way that we clean ourselves in the bathroom.
Toilet paper is a manual technology that requires a hands-on method for cleanup. And if that stuff rips, you're shit out of luck.
Number 10, pus-filled blisters. Yup, it's just as stomach-churning as it sounds. Blisters filled up with pus may appear under or around the nail as a byproduct of a disease called paronychia. They're usually accompanied by swelling, redness, and pain. Paronychia is typically the result of a bacterial infection caused by trauma to the cuticle or nail fold. It can come from picking a hangnail, nail biting, ingrown nails, or injuries associated with splinters and thorns.
Fortunately, a swift round of antibiotics usually gets rid of paronychia. Pop quiz, hotshot! What is the best way to make sure that your hands are bacteria-free? See if you can guess the correct answer in the comments below and stay tuned for the right method later in the video.
Number 9, fungi. Nail fungus is a common occurrence among people of all ages. It's a condition known by the tongue-twisting name of onychomycosis, which starts as a yellow or white spot beneath the nail. Statistically, it accounts for more than half of all nail diseases. As the condition progresses, the nail becomes thicker, brittle, and gains a yellowish color. Ugh. Their shape can become distorted and may start to give off a slightly foul smell. Onychomycosis, in mild forms, isn't that dangerous and is generally more common with toenails than fingernails. That being said, even the verbal association of fingernails and fungus is enough to make most people queasy. Number 8. Earwax, one of our most disgusting bodily secretions, sometimes finds its way under the fingernails as well.
There's no point in acting coy. We all know how it gets there. Cleaning the inside of the ear by way of fingernail might be super tempting, but it's a terrible idea.
That's mainly because it can be dangerous for the ear canals. And the longer your nail, the higher the risk of injury. Some medical professionals don't even recommend using Q-tips to clean the ear. What we know as earwax is actually called cerumen, a substance secreted in the ear canal that protects it from foreign elements such as insects, bacteria, or fungi. Number 7. Nose picking is another common practice that's usually frowned upon. There are also certain risks associated with it, aside from getting odd looks and ending up with snot under the fingernails. One would be nosebleeds caused by sharp nails rupturing blood vessels on the nasal wall. Another risk is introducing bacteria in the nose flora. This happens through dirty nails or fingers, which may cause illness or infection. If the person who picks has a cold or another type of virus, nose picking increases the risk of transmission to other people through hand contact. However, there's a particularly disgusting twist to this practice. Hold on to your lunch! Some doctors argue that the practice of mucophagy, also known as eating the extracted mucus, is beneficial for the body. The mixture of antiseptic enzymes that it contains offers a boost to the immune system by basically training the body's defenses. I think I'll skip that workout. Thank you very much. Number 6, blood. Put your magnifying glass away. This doesn't have anything to do with forensics or tracking down an elusive criminal. Blood usually gathers under the fingernail as a result of trauma, such as getting your finger caught in a door or accidentally hitting it with a heavy object. It's known as subungual hematoma, and one of its symptoms is the nail getting dark coloration. It can turn shades of black, purple, brown, or red. The other, and arguably more important symptom, is an intense throbbing pain. This is caused by the pressure of blood that is gathering between the nail bed and the fingernail. In case the pain is too much to bear, doctors can perform a type of decompression called trepanation. It's one of those rare situations where the treatment sounds more painful than the injury.
Trepanation involves using a heated wire or a carbon laser to make holes in the nail and relieve the pressure.
It might sound like torture, but it's actually a quick and painless procedure. If the nail bed isn't damaged, the nail will actually fall off on its own as it gradually separates from it. A couple of months later, you'll be the proud owner of a brand new fingernail. Number 5.
As the largest bodily organ, the skin goes through a continuous process of change and regeneration. About 1 month from now, your skin will be entirely new. Oh my God, your skin looks amazing. Well, thank you, I just got it.
That's usually how long it takes for new skin cells to make their way to the top skin layer, also known as the epidermis. Once they get there, they die and break away, making room for the new ones growing from below. So where do the dead skin cells go, you might ask? It's simple. Just check your fingernails. In a full day, human beings shed about 1 million skin cells. Every time you scratch any part of your body, you're essentially scooping them up. It's one of the reasons why our nails sometimes look so discolored. Number 4. Nail-tooth connection. It wouldn't be a stretch to say that a tooth often gets under a nail as well, usually with the purpose of chomping bits off it. Aside from the social stigma that it carries, nail biting can be dangerous for all the body parts involved. It can damage the teeth and gums as well as the finger and nails. Years of biting may lead to damage of the nail bed and severely deformed nails. Breaking the skin of the cuticle makes the nail more susceptible to infection. A wide variety of microbes may live under the fingernail, which are thus transmitted to the mouth. Chronic nail biting, known as onychophagia, is sometimes the consequence of certain mental disorders, such as OCD. In these cases, consulting a doctor or mental health provider is usually the best course of action. Yet for the common nail biting enthusiast, there are some simpler remedies. One cheap slash effective method is applying a clear, bitter tasting nail polish, which in time discourages the habit. I had to use that method to stop sucking my thumb. Fun Gavin fact. Number 3.
Now it's time to go over some of the villains of the seedy world that lies beneath your fingernails.
One of them is a bacteria called Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It can cause chloronychia, also known as green nail syndrome. Your nail gets greenish in color, but the condition is normally treatable. Nevertheless, in more severe infections, Pseudomonas aeruginosa has remarkable antibiotic resistance mechanisms. It's particularly effective in infecting people that already have reduced immunity or damaged tissue. It thrives in moist environments, which is why it's commonly found in and on medical equipment. However, the CDC studies carried out in medical facilities have also discovered its presence underneath nails, particularly artificial ones. Once it finds its way to a hospital or a clinic, this noxious bacteria can cause extremely dangerous cross-infections. Number 2. This is another upper echelon member of the undernail baddies. Staphylococcus aureus is present in 20 to 30% of the population, usually without doing them any harm. Yet this bacteria can also become an opportunistic pathogen causing a vast number of diseases. This is more commonly known as a staph infection, and they range from pimples, boils, and rashes to potentially fatal diseases such as meningitis, sepsis, pneumonia, or osteomyelitis. In the US alone, about 50,000 people lose their lives each year due to staph infections. The scariest aspect is that there's no vaccine for a staph infection, and some strains have even developed resistance to antibiotics. A study carried out among healthcare workers has discovered that those with acrylic nails are more at risk for harboring the bacteria. Even after washing their hands with antibacterial soap, the bacterium was still present in significant cases.
It's answer time! According to Dr. Chris Van Tullekan, the best way to rid your hands of bacteria is to wash them with soap and water and rub vigorously. Do that for as long as it takes to sing the happy birthday song 2 times, and then your hands will be clean.
Number one, E. coli. Before you get too alarmed about a gang of E. coli living under your fingernails, you should know that harmless strains are already present in your gut. E. coli is found among the normal microbes of the human body, where it develops a symbiotic relationship. It can help the host organism by producing vitamin K2 and preventing more dangerous bacteria from forming colonies in the intestine. However, there are also pathogenic, disease-causing types of E. coli, which usually develop outside of the human body. These strains may also end up under your fingernails if you don't wash your hands properly. They are then commonly introduced to the body through habitual nail biting. It's worth mentioning that some of the cases of E. coli strains are known to cause serious food poisoning and even a life-threatening condition. They've been the reason behind the recall of numerous commercial food products. So, to avoid a visit from the more dangerous members of the E. coli family, make sure to maintain proper hand and fingernail hygiene.
Thanks for watching! What's the weirdest thing you've ever got under your fingernails? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to hit that notification button to keep up with our latest videos. Bye!